This is the inside story of your senses, the Sensational Five. And here to tell you about them is the one and only Slim Goodbody.
Open up your eyes, it's amazing. The ability we have for gazing. Listen to the sounds that are everywhere. Smell the fragrances in the air. Reach over and touch a plum, then taste its flavor on your tongue. Simply said, your senses are sensational. These five help us survive quite happily. There's such delight the world can give, because we're very sensitive. We really ought to celebrate. So here and now I'm gonna state, our senses are sensational. Our senses keep us in constant contact with the outside world. They introduce us to its wonders, and they warn us of its dangers. These Sensational Five are our own natural teachers, and they send the information that they gather to our big boss brain. Now let's begin to see how this all works with our sense of sight. Now, when we come to talk of sight, first we must discuss the light that enters through into our eyes. Because on light our sight relies. Did you ever stop to realize the importance of our pair of eyes? There really is so much that we can do. We've got our eyes to see us through. Vision begins with light. If you were in a pitch black room, you couldn't see anything at all. But once there's light, those rays of light will bounce off an object and stream back. Some will enter into your eye. Now, at the front of your eye is a transparent window called the cornea. The cornea is curved and it bulges out just slightly. When the light rays enter the cornea, they're directed inwards towards each other. Now, this directing is called focusing. Behind the cornea is a ring of muscles called the iris. The iris controls the size of the pupil. It also gives your eye its color. Now, if the light is very dim, the iris can open up the size of the pupil. If the light is too bright, it can close down the size of the pupil. Behind the iris is the lens. The lens does the fine focusing because it can change shape from thin and flat to curved and thick. Now, once the light is finely focused, it's projected onto the retina, which is at the rear of the eye. The retina is kind of like a movie screen, except that it's curved. Once the light rays hit the retina, they're transformed into electrical impulses, which are transmitted along the optic nerve to your brain, which forms a mental picture of what your eye is seeing. You've got your eyes to see you through. Those eyes. Now let's see how all of these parts work together to create your sensational sense of sight. Light rays are bouncing off of me in all directions. Some of them enter the eye. Now notice how the cornea and lens bend these rays, making them cross over before they reach the retina. This means that the image on the retina is upside down. The iris is adjusting automatically so that the image is not too bright or too dim. The focusing of the lens is automatic too. You never really have to think about it. Now the nerve impulses from the image on the retina are sent to the brain. Your brain then turns things right side up, making a mental picture of what you're seeing. Your sense of sight is sensational. Did you ever stop to realize the importance of your pair of eyes? There really is so much that they can do. You've got your eyes to see you through. Just look at all the things you see, the world surrounding you and me, at every glance a visual delight. You know it's right to love your sight. Now look at these scenes. Can you tell what's missing from them? Listen, and I'll tell you what you want to hear.
The world is filled with beautiful sounds. You know there's such a variety. But there's something they all have in common, and that something happens to be vibrations.
Sound begins when something vibrates. That means it moves back and forth fast enough in order to push the air around it out and away in waves. Sound waves. Now, sound waves travel out in all directions, and your ear is specially designed to pick up these sound waves and transmit the information to the brain. When you look at someone's ear, you're really only seeing a part of it, because the rest is hidden inside of the head. The outer ear here collects and concentrates the sound waves, which then travel through this canal until they reach the eardrum, which is a thin piece of skin. When the sound waves beat against this eardrum, they cause it to vibrate slightly. If the sounds are low, like this, the vibration will be slow. If the sounds are high, like this, the vibrations will be much faster. Next, the vibrations are passed along these three bones, which are among the tiniest in your body. They're called the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup because of the way that they're shaped. Now, they pass along the vibration like this, either fast or slow, until they reach the inner portion of your ear called the cochlea. Now, the cochlea resembles a snail shell and has the job of passing along the sound vibrations and changing them into nerve impulses, which are then passed to your brain. You know, it's really amazing when you stop to think about it, because all of this action is taking place in such a tiny space. Why, the cochlea here is no bigger than the tip of your pinky, and these three bones could fit into a box no bigger than a sugar cube. And yet, we are able to hear over 400,000 different sounds, from a whisper to the roar of a jet plane. Our hearing and sight are two very important senses. Well, just think of all the information we receive from listening to others talking or from reading. But what happens when someone is missing a sense? Without eyesight, you learn to hear things you would hardly notice otherwise. Another sense you would depend on much more is touch. The organ of touch is the largest organ in your body. Where is it? All over. It's your skin. Now, what will wrap me up and keep me in? Skin. And what's my outside hide that keeps my fluids inside? Skin. Do I love my skin? Yes, very much. Because it's sensitive to everything I touch. Such a comfortable place to live in skin. You know, your skin is really a very incredible and complex organ. It's made up of several different layers and contains many different things, like blood vessels, hair follicles, sweat and oil glands, and nerves. Now, nerves are what gives us our sense of touch, and we've got millions and millions of them in our skin. But not all nerves are the same. Oh, no. There are several different types which produce different sensations. Touch and pressure nerves let you know when things are rough, soft, hard, or smooth. Temperature nerves tell you when things are hot and cold. And pain nerves tell you when things itch or tickle or hurt, so they can warn you of a dangerous situation.
Ouch.
Here's another sense organ that can give our body protection. This is an air conditioner because it puts the air in the best condition to come into our body. It cleans it, it warms it, and it even filters out most of the germs before they can cause any trouble. But one of the nicest things about the nose is that it can smell. I love the smell of bakery bread. Its rich aroma fills my head, and I could walk for hours smelling flowers. But how do we smell flowers? Well, chemicals are released by flowers and the other things we smell into the air and get carried to the nose. Now, we can't see an aroma because the amount of these chemicals is so small, but we can smell it because here, deep inside of the nose, is a special group of super sensitive cells called the olfactory area. These cells get stimulated by the chemicals and send their message through the olfactory nerve up to the brain. Now, this lets us smell anything from onions to oranges to fish to even a skunk. P.U. We can recognize thousands and thousands of different odors. And like sight and hearing, smelling is a distant sense. That means we can smell good food cooking, even when we're far from the kitchen. But taste is different. I mean, you can't taste things from a distance, unless, of course, you happen to have a very long tongue. You see, your tongue is covered with thousands of tiny receptors called taste buds. When they get touched, they send a message to your brain about what that substance is that you're tasting. But not all these taste buds do the same thing. You see, the taste buds in front, they taste sweet things. That's why you lick an ice cream cone. The taste buds in back, they taste bitter things. That's why you don't notice a bitter taste as fast as you do a sweet one. The taste buds here at the sides taste salty and sour things. Now, here is an experiment to try. Take some salt and place it on the tip of your tongue. Now, since the receptors here basically only taste sweet things, you shouldn't be able to taste that salt at all. Your sense of smell can also affect your taste. If you smell an onion while eating an apple, the apple will probably taste somewhat like an onion. On the other hand, if you have a cold and your nose is stuffed, you can barely taste your food at all. Just think how lucky you are when you can smell, taste, and enjoy all the good things you eat. Senses are truly sensational. In countless and exciting ways, they let the world come through. And now you know some of the things your senses do for you. But take good care of yourself so your senses can work in the best way possible. Senses send their information reporting to your brain. Revealing feelings, tastes and smells, sights and sounds of the world all around. There's a constant reception, and all this perception keeps on coming. There's a steady humming. This sensitive team keeps beaming a stream, giving life a meaning, receiving the world, perceiving the world. Into the world, in touch with the world.